This morning, we have part two of our exclusive interview with music mogul Sean Jay-Z Carter. So we took you on a tour of Brooklyn Public Library's expansive Book of Hov exhibit yesterday, where Hov himself was our guide. I can't lie, that was very, very cool. Today, we'll get to know more about the man behind the music. It's another side to Jay-Z, the family man with a ginormous heart. Only on CBS Mornings, he shares a part of the exhibit that brought tears to his family and to his eyes. But first, I can't help it, a reintroduction.
Allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is Ho.
This might be the most dynamic room of the Book of Hov exhibit. Footage from some of Jay-Z's biggest shows light up every corner, including that time he made history as the Glastonbury Festival's first hip-hop headliner in England.
So Glastonbury, this was a big deal because there was some skepticism about you being on that stage. Like, what's a rapper doing in Glastonbury?
Yeah. Yeah.
But that didn't deter you.
At one point, I was like, why am I going there? They don't want me there, I won't go. And then Chris from Coldplay was instrumental in that.
Chris Martin.
Yeah, he was like, Jay, they love you. It's just like these old, the old guard, they don't know. Like, it's always been a rock festival. They didn't have anything against me personally. It was just like, this is a rock festival. This is what it is.
So
but the world was changing.
Jay-Z asked guitarists on his team to teach him Wonderwall by Oasis right before the show, after a member of the rock band said rap didn't belong at Glastonbury.
And luckily, it was four chords. It was almost like, doom, 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 then repeat.
So they say you guys ain't want me to be here tonight.
That moment, it was, I could have done anything.
I guess I got my swagger back.
His trip down memory lane doesn't end there. This studio is an almost exact replica of the one Jay-Z commissioned to create iconic records like The Blueprint.
I don't know if he had a good time, but I sure did.
We all did.
I had such a good time.
You know, before you start, let me say this. I'm a huge Jay-Z fan. I've seen just about every interview.
Me too. Yeah.
That is the best Jay-Z interview I've ever seen in my life.
Oh, thanks. He really came to play, too, Nate. He really came to play. And he gave us a lot of time, as I said yesterday. But one of the most touching things to me, there was a young security guard in one of the rooms. Eric was his name. Jay hadn't gotten there yet. And I said, what are you thinking about this? He said, it just inspires me. I don't know him. I admire this man. It just inspires me, and it shows what hard work can do. But the great comments online, we may not have Jay-Z's gifts, but it does remind us that we can all be beacons of light and hope in this world. And I think the most fascinating part was to see the love in his eyes to speak about his music and his story. And what a story he has. The exhibit, if you haven't seen it, you must run, don't walk, people, to the library. That's another thing. It's in the library, and it's free. It's there till December 4th. Yeah. People are saying, take it on the road.
Well, Jay-Z, that's a Rock Nation. You for getting Gayle King to Brooklyn. I appreciate it.
Tony's been trying forever.
It's hard to do.
It's so far.